Hello bookish friends, welcome to my October wrap-up part 1. In this video, I will talk about the 4 works that I finished in the first half of October. And like I did in my previous wrap-ups, I will insert the clips that I recorded very soon after I finished those works. Today is the 6th of October and I finished 2 works today. The first one was the audiobook that I was listening for 5 days. It was also the most current book in Love at Stake series, which I'm buddy reading with Amy at Sobek. Wild About You by Carolyn Sparks. In this book, we follow Howard, who's a shapeshifter who turns into a bear called Werebear. He's been infatuated with the star of the TV show in which her team rebuilds or redecorates old homes. Elsa is like a dream girl for Howard. And when Howard's employer, Shanna, realizes Howard's crush on Elsa, she decides to play the matchmaker and bring Elsa and Howard together by offering a house renovation job for the team. Elsa has a curse that is very much connected with werewolves and werebears. And although Howard and Elsa are very much attracted to each other at first, they have to find out if they will be affected by this curse or not. I quite enjoyed this addition to the series. Howard and Elsa are very likable main characters, and their chemistry was quite good. And the build-up to the last battle scene, which always happens belonging to the books in this series, was very, very well done. However, the last battle in this one actually did not meet the high expectations. It was good, but it could have been better. I also had a problem with some of the language that is used in the romantic scenes. But overall, it was a quite enjoyable book. I felt good while listening to it. Second work that I finished was the first work that I read for Victober, which was a short story written by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. It is actually said to be Doyle's first short story, The Mystery of Sasasa Valley. In this very short work, we hear adventures of two young men who are in South Africa trying to discover a legendary jewel. When I finished the story, I thought that my copy was incomplete. I downloaded another copy to see if the story really ended that way or not. Because I think the ending was very, very bad, and I could not understand the point of the story. I can clearly believe that this short story was the first work of Doyle, because he has grown significantly better at plot structure. So overall, I gave this short story my lowest rating so far, which is 4 out of 10. Today is the 8th of October and I finished the book that I was buddy reading with Angie at Angie and the Great World, which is titled Sürpulluğunu Ölülerin Kemikleri Üzerinde by Olga Tocharczuk. This book, originally written in Polish, was translated to English as Drive Your Plow Over the Bones of the Dead. This book takes place in a very remote Polish village near the border of Czechia. Janina is our main character, who's the caretaker of some of the houses in the land, and she's also a part-time English teacher in the village. And she's very interested in spending her times studying astrology and translating the poetry of William Blake, with a former student of hers. And her reputation as a crank and a recluse is amplified by her not-so-secret preference for the company of animals over humans. When some residents of the town are mysteriously found dead in very short periods after each other, Janina claims that because they were all hunters, they were killed by the animals because they wanted to take revenge. This work is quite popular among the book lovers in my country, and I had put it on my TBR because of that. And when Angie said that this book was a book that she wanted to read, we decided to read it together. Maybe because it is praised a lot in the country. I was quite disappointed by this work. Although through the end, I quite liked the twist in the plot. The whole book felt very, very weird. It was a weirdly structured. The main character was extremely weird, with her fixation on astrology and extreme love of animals. And many of the chapters written in stream of conscious method really made me feel unable to follow some of the chapters, although I had no trouble understanding the general plot. Actually, the only thing that impressed me was how well the physical environment was described in the book. But I really had trouble understanding why this author is an award-winning author. Overall, I gave Sürpulluğunu Ölülerin Kemikleri Üstünden, Drive Your Plow Over the Bones of the Dead a 6 out of 10. Today is the 15th of October, and I finished the audiobook that I was listening for a while, which was a Turkish book, Yaban by Yakup Kadri Karaosmanoğlu. This book has also been translated to English as Mother Earth. I will make a dedicated Turkish shelf video, which will be online most probably in a few days. In this book, we follow a retired army doctor who has been wounded in the First World War, and after experiencing PTSD and not finding a meaningful life in his old environment, he decides to spend his life in the village of one of the soldiers that he commanded in the army. When they come to this small village very near Eskişehir, the resistance against the occupation of Anatolia after the First World War leads to Turkish independence war with the Greeks. Our doctor Cemal is very much impressed with this new resistant and has very high hopes for the future of the country. However, he changes his mind as he lives with the villagers. His feelings towards them changes from arrogance to disgust, to hate, to understanding, and finally accepting defeat and become a solitary man. This book is considered to be the first naturalistic novel in the modern Turkish history. Aside from nature descriptions and the way that the story is told in a rural village, I think what impressed me the most about this book was the realistic approach to everybody, including the main character. Against the backdrop of the independence war, it was interesting how the way that we were taught that Anatolia all over supported the resistance movement was not very true, considering that this book was written only 10 years after the big victory that we had against the Greeks. I found the writing style to be very, very approachable, and I will certainly read more books from this author. And I gave Yaban by Yakup Kadri Karaosmanoğlu an 8 out of 10. So those were the four works that I finished in the first half of October. Please comment down below, have you read any of the works that are mentioned in this video, and what did you think of them? If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose wild. Wild means vahşi in Turkish, and vahşi is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!